2021 was a big year for Baldur's Gate 3. Not only was the existing content in the Act 1 expanded on, we also got two new classes being the Druid and the Sorcerer. But it does beg the question, what's left? So, let's get into it. Hey, this video is brought to you by you. Let me know down in the comments below what content you would like to see added to Baldur's Gate 3 Early Access next, or what you're most anticipating for the full release of the game. Let's go! Sven Wittke, I always say his name wrong, so many apologies, has said in an interview with Eurogamer, which is linked in the comments down below if you want to have a read of it yourself, that they are only specifically adding the player handbook content to the game. So that gives us a very clear look at the classes and races that are still to come. We can also have a rough guess around what else is coming based on things they've done in the past through Divinity Original Sin. Also, let me know in the comments down below what content you are most excited for. We'll start off with races. Now, currently in the game, we have the Dwarf, the Elf, the Half-Elf, Halfling, Human, and Tiefling. Now, still to come from the player handbook is the Dragonborn, which is my favorite race. I can't wait for them to be added to the game. We also have gnomes coming. There is a gnome in the early access currently. We just can't play as them. And both of the variants, the Forest and the Rock, we haven't actually got yet. And the last race is the Half-Orc. They're the three races that we are waiting to be added left to the game. More exciting than the races, in my opinion, is the classes and the ones that we're missing from the game. Some classes have all of their subclasses in the game, some of them have only a couple, and then some of them are completely missing from the game. In the game currently, we have the Cleric, the Druid, the Fighter, the Ranger, Rogue, Sorcerer, Warlock, and Wizard. Of the classes that we currently have in the game, for the Cleric, we are missing four of the subclasses, Knowledge, Nature, Tempest, and War. For the Fighter, we're missing one subclass being Champion, the Rogue, we're missing one being Assassin, and Warlock, we are also missing one being Archfey. The Wizard is missing the most. We're missing six subclasses from the Wizard, being Conjuration, Divination, Enchantment, Illusion, Necromancy, and Transmutation. Now, there are four classes that are entirely missing from the game, and the first one is Barbarian, which I guess if you don't know D&D, you could relate it. It's very similar to a Fighter. It's a martial type class, but it's based around a rage mechanic. It has two subclasses that we are waiting for. We are also waiting for the Bard, which uses the power of music and their words to give buffs to allies, damage enemies, even heal wounds through the power of music. Pretty cool ability if you ask me. They have two subclasses, Lore and Valor, which we're waiting on. Also waiting on the Monk, which is a similar kind of martial type class as well. However, they harness the power of key energy to do their various magical effects and enhance their body's physical abilities to punch things really hard, more or less, if you want to break it down to a simple level. The Monk has three subclasses, Shadow, Four Elements, and Open Hand, that we're waiting to be added to the game. And the Paladin is the last class, which is kind of similar to a Cleric in a way. It's like a priest that is also like a half tank, so you can heal as well as protect your allies using your Paladin abilities. They have three subclasses in the player handbook, Ancients, Devotion, and Vengeance. So holistically for classes, we still have four whole classes to come into the game, as well as some subclasses for five of the existing classes. Outside of this as a base level, we do have to do a little bit of speculation around the content that's still coming to the game, because the story that Larian Studios are telling in the game isn't really in the player handbook. That's just really breaking down the fundamentals of the game and its mechanics, its races, its classes, whereas they're telling their own story. So looking at something like companions, we can't really guarantee that we're going to get a certain amount of companions, but Sven has said in the past that we will be getting more companions at launch, but he hasn't given any specific details, but we can kind of speculate what we can expect here. Divinity Original Sin 1 had five companions, Divinity Original Sin 2 had six. Right now in Baldur's Gate 3, we have five. It's unreasonable to think that we're going to get a companion for all 12 classes, but I personally would expect at least one more to come into the game. Probably a healer type that is kind of good aligned, because if you look at Shadowheart and especially all the other characters except Gale, really, most of them are neutral or evil aligned, and they're all kind of, you know, not very nice people, I guess. So we are absolutely, I believe, going to get some kind of good aligned character, probably a paladin of some description that kind of fits that, you know, righteous paladin mindset. Of the companions that we do have, there are three spell wielders and two martial archetypes. And the martial archetypes available in the early access as a whole is pretty lacking. So you could also see something maybe like a barbarian be added, or a monk as one of the possible companions. Typically the companion archetypes are usually the easier to play classes. So you're not really going to see something like a druid or a sorcerer be added as a companion class. It's usually the easier classes or archetypes to play so that you can ease yourself into the game. If you don't want to create your own character, you can play as them, or they're just easy to manage as your party members that follow you, so you don't have to spend too much time playing around in the intricacies of a complex class. The last major piece of content that we can expect in the game really is the rest of the game, like the other content being Act 2 and Act 3. Currently, the game has multiple solutions on how you can end Act 1, but when you do end Act 1, the game is over. It just says GG, thanks for playing. We still have Act 2 and Act 3 to go, and it's hard to directly speculate on where these acts will actually take us. Larian typically have each of their game acts break up into a large, expansive area where you can explore, do all of the quests and everything like that. Then once you've completed the main arc of that act, you then move to a new area. In the Act 1 early access at the moment, we're kind of playing around in this free open area. It's kind of a tutorial-y thing. There's lots of things to do. I would expect in the next act, at least probably in Act 2, it'll take you to Baldur's Gate, the city itself. I mean, the game is called Baldur's Gate. It would only make sense we actually go there. I would expect this in Act 2 because that's probably the biggest expansion act that the games usually have. That's their massive act. And then in Act 3, it kind of gets a little bit more narrower as you are ending towards the end of the game based on your quest threads and story arcs being kind of completed. There is plenty of that in Act 1 that we currently have that still needs to be resolved, and it's going to be interesting to see where Larian take a lot of these story threads and how the game really evolves around the Mind Flayers and the story that they're trying to tell here. Let me know in the comments down below what you would like to see added to the game next, and if you are excited for the full release, what do you think about the game as a whole? Thank you for watching this video to the end. Thank you to our members for supporting the channel. My name is Norza, and I hope you have a great day.